Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station Update Hour. We're joining the International Space Station Flight Control Team in the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Mission Control Center in Houston, where the Orbit 2 team is on console at this time. And they're led today by Flight Director Paul Dye with astronaut CJ Sturkow in the Capcom seat. You can see Dye and Sturkow here. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 31 crew has been awake since 1 a.m. Central Time. Commander Oleg Kononenko and U.S. Flight Engineers Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin, that's Russian Flight Engineers Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin, as well as U.S. Flight Engineers Don Pettit and Joe Acaba and European Flight Engineer Andre Kuipers, are now all more than halfway through a busy day of science and maintenance activities as well as transfer work. They're currently orbiting 252 miles above southern Africa, heading north towards the Indian Ocean. Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit have been at the space station since December. They launched into space on December 21st and docked on the 23rd. Now, with 167 days in space and 165 at the space station, they're coming up on the end of their sojourn. They're scheduled to return to Earth on July 1st. Their crewmates, Acaba, Padalka, and Revin, still have most of their mission in front of them. They only launched from Baikonur on May 14th and arrived at the station on May 16th, which means they've now spent 21 days in space and 19 at the space station. They won't be alone for long, however, after Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit leave. They'll be joined in a couple of weeks after that by what will then be the rest of the Expedition 32 crew. That's Sonny Williams, Yuri Malenchenko, and Aki Hoshide. Those three are scheduled to launch from Baikonur on July 15th. Preparations for all of those activities are ongoing both here on the ground and in space. Williams, Malenchenko, and Hoshide are currently at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, Russia, and today they took part in a suited Soyuz simulation. Meanwhile, on board the space station, Acaba spent an hour of handover time with Pettit yesterday, and today did the same with Kuipers. Of course, this mission still has a lot to do before the next one starts. Today, Don Pettit is working to replace a short-circuited power supply for the Japanese Ryute experiment, its processing unit, to be exact. He and Joe Acaba are also spending some time today with the BASS experiment, which stands for the Burning and Suppression of Solids experiment. And that tests the hypothesis that, all other things being equal, materials in microgravity burn as well or better than they would in gravity. Joe Acaba is also doing a round of monitoring for the integrated cardiovascular experiment today, which looks at how the body's cardiovascular system reacts to being in space. And Andre Kuipers is doing some health monitoring of his own for another experiment, this one the VO2 Max experiment, which works to document how astronauts' ability to do strenuous physical activity changes during their time in space. And finally, on the Russian side of the space station, the cosmonauts were also participating in a couple of science experiments. Gennady Padalka was again today scheduled to work on the Kolonovsky crystal experiment, which studies the effect of microgravity on charged particles in a magnetic field. And Sergey Revin had some time set aside to work on an experiment that monitors group activities under spaceflight conditions. That's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.